Sue and I are up here in the mountains where we're always at, you know, and we're actually down the hill now by some really awesome ponds here and a creek back over here on the other side. And very quiet, beautifully quiet. Oh my God, so quiet because of the ice and the snow. Very few people are on the roads today. We're quite a ways off the main road right now, so we probably wouldn't hear anything very well in the distance. Anyway, I take just a minute here to talk about the power structure that we live under and how you can change it as an individual. First off, we're looking for change in the wrong place. Change doesn't happen. Really beneficial, positive change for all of us, the average person, doesn't happen from the top down. It's not a trickle-down thing. It doesn't work that way. It goes from the bottom up. We have to change as individuals. The choices are our lifestyle choices, our purchasing choices. That needs to change dramatically. We need to try to work at becoming not necessarily non-consumers. I buy stuff, but it's how we consume. Are you going to your local farmer's market? Now, all of us realize, in individual conversation, is that the corporations are controlling the political process. Therefore, we're being ruled by the corporations. The corporations' power comes purely from their money, and their money comes purely from us being hoodwinked into purchasing their products at their major giant stores and thinking, being led to think that we have to have more, more, more. Buying cheap crap and then it busts and we have to go back and get more cheap crap. Instead of saving a little bit of money, buying maybe a better quality thing, you know, keeping care of it and helping it to last longer. So the waste that we have connected to the money we spend on that connects to the power they have, and they end up ruling us. If you'd like to make a fundamental change in the power structure on this planet, or at least in this country, then you have to work on how you purchase things. You know, it's very important to work very hard at purchasing less, buy as much as you can from the local farmers markets and crafters markets. Try to keep your money local. When you keep your money local, you don't support these corporations as much. Even when it's a local guy in a little small business selling something that comes from somewhere else, you're keeping more money in your community. That's good. Try to buy things that are made local as much as possible. Try to buy food that's grown locally as much as possible. Because you as an individual will do your part to hamstring these giant corporations that really have us all with their fingers wrapped tightly around our necks, and they're choking us to death. And they're trying to squeeze out every last little bit of life that we have through their corporate rule, which is manifest through their political rule because they own the politicians. So I'm just making this message today that you have the power to change the face of this planet, more than likely. If not that, at least you can change the entire structure of how the United States works, and that would affect the planet greatly in an extremely positive way. Would not be a bad thing at all. Instead of large corporations hiring thousands and thousands and thousands of people, you'd have small little startups in local areas hiring a few people at a time, but thousands of times over in all the different locations, and all those people would have work. We would all have greater control over our lives, and we take control out of the corporate hands. Can I say that, sir?
No.